In this video, I'm going to show you how to install Windows 11 with a local account using a USB drive. Normally, Windows requires you to install with a Microsoft account, as you see here, and you will not have the option to install it in any other way. With this method, we will enable the option to install without an internet connection, which allows you to set up with just a local user account, as you could with previous versions of Windows. This works great for fresh new builds or clean reinstalls. You will need a USB drive 8 GB or larger for this. Be sure the USB drive has nothing you want on it, since everything on it will be deleted. You will need a computer connected to the internet for downloading and creating the installation of media. I also recommend only having the drive you plan to install Windows on connected, so there's no confusion about which drive you're going to be installing it on. Before we get to the installation, I'm going to show you quickly what to do if you're planning on doing this on a computer running Windows 10 already. If doing it on a new build, then you will not need to be doing this part. First, run a PC health check to determine if you can install Windows 11 on the PC currently running Windows 10. PC health check is probably already installed on your Windows 10 computer, and you can just type PC health check into the Windows search and it will come up. Now, if it does not show up already installed on your computer, you can go to the Windows 11 website to get it, which we will include a link to in the description. On the download page, just scroll to the bottom and click on the link to download the PC health check app. Now save the file to a location and remember where you saved it, for you can find it. And then once it's downloaded, we're going to navigate to that location that you saved it. And we'll just double click on the file to launch the PC health check app. Once you run the PC health check, you should see the button at the top that says check now. Click on that and it should tell you if your computer is compatible. There are ways of installing Windows on unsupported systems, but I'll not be covering that in this video. Once you determine that your computer is compatible, then we can move on to the next step. On the Windows 11 download page, in which we'll include a link to in the description, you will want to find the section labeled Create Windows 11 Installation Media. It is a good idea to read the Before You Begin section for information about the install. Next, you'll want to click on the Download Now button and download the Media Creation Tool to your computer. At this point, if you have not inserted the USB drive into your computer, you should do so now. Be sure to note the drive letters so you use the correct USB in the next step. Navigate to where you downloaded the Media Creation Tool, double click, and hit OK if it asks for permission to run it. Once it launches, it'll take a few seconds, and then you should get the license agreement, which you'll need to accept. And once you accept, you should be presented with the language and edition that you'd like to install. By default, it's going to go with the recommended for this computer, and those won't be changeable. If you want to change those, you will need to uncheck that box. And then you can change which options that you want, and then you can just hit next after that to go to the next step. Now you'll want to choose USB flash drive, since that's what we're going to be using here. Then click next, and you'll be presented with which drive you want to use. If you have more than one drive, you'll have to know which drive letter from before that you want to use. And once you've chosen which drive you want to use, you can click Next. At this point, after a few seconds, it should start to create your installation media. And you can just basically walk away, give it a few minutes, because this does take a little bit of time, especially depending on your internet connection. And we sped this video up considerably because we know nobody wants to sit here and watch that download and install. Once this process is completed, if you're just installing on the computer you're currently using, you can just leave the USB drive installed. Otherwise, you're going to want to safely eject that USB drive, and we're going to be inserting it into the computer we'll be installing Windows 11 onto at this point. At this point, we are ready to boot to the USB drive. How to do this will vary depending on the brand of the computer and how it is configured. What you need to do is tell the computer to boot to the USB drive instead of the regular hard drive. If you are installing to a new hard drive, then your computer will most likely boot to the USB by itself. But if you already have an operating system installed, you will most likely need to do this. And to do that, we will need to enter the BIOS. The most common way to go into the BIOS to change the boot order on most computers is to press the F1 key or the delete key repeatedly while the system is booting until you see the BIOS screen. Your BIOS will most likely be different, but they are usually very similar. You'll want to find the boot menu, which may be in the advanced options. On ours, we'll change the first boot option to the USB drive, and the second option to the Windows Boot Manager, or whatever drive was listed number 1 to start. And this will be much easier if you only have the drive you plan on installing Windows onto and the USB drive. And some BIOSes might have a boot override like ours does here, so we can directly boot to that USB drive. Once your boot order is changed, you can just exit and save the changes and reset your computer, and we'll boot directly into the install media. Now, if your boot order is properly changed, you should now boot to the USB drive. And after a few moments, you should be presented with the Windows setup. At this point, you'll want to change any language or keyboard settings, and then we'll just click Next. Then click on Install Now. You will then be asked to enter your Windows product key. You can often use your Windows 10 product key to activate it if it is still valid for a free upgrade. Otherwise, you will need to buy Windows 11 to get a product key. I usually wait and activate Windows after installing. But you can enter and activate at this point as well. If you are entering the product key later, like I am, just choose I don't have a product key. If you are not entering a product key at this moment, you'll have to let it know which version you'd like to install. Be sure to choose the one that you have a product key for. Here we are installing Windows Home, so I will just choose that and click Next. Then you will need to accept the license agreement and click Next again. You will then be presented with the option to upgrade or do a custom install, which is what we want to do. Now we need to choose where to install Windows. On this drive, we already had an operating system, so you'll see other partitions already set up. We're going to go ahead and actually just delete all of those until we have only one drive with allocated space. Now do be careful if you have more than one drive installed, and make sure you're doing it to the correct drive. This is why it's recommended to only have the drive you're installing Windows on connected when doing this. What you see here is exactly what you also see with a new drive. Now we'll choose that drive and just click Next. The installation process should then start and may take some time. We've sped up this video to make it much quicker, and your computer may reboot a couple times during this process. And just a reminder, before doing this, make sure any data is backed up, because this does wipe everything from the drive. At this point, I recommend going get a cup of coffee, something to drink, or a bite to eat, because everything goes slower when you're watching it. Up to this point, we've done everything we would with a normal install, but this is where we need to change the steps to bypass the Microsoft account and internet requirement. In order for this to work, you'll need to make sure that the computer is not connected to the internet, so unplug a network cable if you have it plugged in. Next, we will hold down the Shift key and press F10 to bring up the command prompt. Once the command prompt is up, we're going to click at the blinking cursor, and you're going to want to type in oobe/bypassnro and hit enter. The computer should then reboot and bring you back to this exact same screen. And once that loads up, then we can first choose the country that we are in, and then choose the keyboard language that we want to use. And if you want to add another one, we're going to skip that. At this point, it would normally want us to connect to the internet, which we do not want to do, because if you are connected to the internet, you will not get the option to set up a local account. So we do not want to be connected to the internet at this point. And you should have the option down at the bottom, I do not have internet. That is what we're going to be clicking on. If you do not see that, then you may not have entered the command properly that we entered previously. So now we'll click on I don't have internet. It's going to try to convince you to set it up with the Microsoft account. We don't want, so we're going to continue with limited setup. Once we've clicked on limited setup, the first thing it's going to want you to do is put your username in. So we're going to go ahead and just put whatever username that you want, and then enter your password as well, and then enter your password again to confirm. And once you've done that, you'll need to set up three security questions in case you forget your password. Now, after you've set up your recovery questions, the next step will ask you for the privacy settings. I personally like to turn off all privacy settings, but that's entirely up to you. So you want to go through, make your decisions on that, and then we're going to go ahead and accept. And normally, if you would set up with a Microsoft account, it would walk you through a whole bunch of options for trials, for Microsoft 365, pretty much everything. You won't get any of those options when you're setting it up this way, so that does streamline the installation setup as well. And once everything is loaded up and you get your Windows 11 screen, you'll be able to go ahead and connect your internet and download and install any drivers that you need to do. Hopefully you found this video helpful, and thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.